I, for one, feel a lot better than I did yesterday. I went out to the Women's Solidarity March today in Sarasota, and it was like the biggest turnout I've ever seen for any kind of protest or event or anything out there. This, under the unconditional surrender, it was just throngs of people everywhere. And to see all these people marching over the bridge together, solidarity, just lifting each other up and just feeling community. The people who drove by even were giving thumbs up, they were honking, they were flashing peace signs. And it was just a real positive experience. It wasn't about being anti-Trump or anything like that. Well, there was some of that, obviously. But mostly it was just this understanding that we are still here for each other. And I think if anything good is going to come from this administration, it's going to force the people of America to really unite, really get behind each other, really support each other. And we're going to have to come together as a community in a way that we may not have ever done before. But I think it's something America has needed for quite a long time. Even Stephen King came out and had a few words and said, you know, hold these people accountable to what it is they do. Get in their face, is what he said over and over again.
It was, no, we can't. Sorry. No, we can't. Guess what? Yes, we can.
Throughout the whole thing, there were a couple of people who like drove by, and I heard somebody say, call us all idiots. Several thousand of us. And I heard, you know, I saw somebody go by with a thumbs down sign, but very few. And one of the things that I'm realizing is that because only 25% of the American population who could vote actually voted for Trump. And those that did, a lot of them just voted for him because he's not a politician. And so I see the people who actually support him and the way he wants to do things is a very small minority. They may be vocal, but there are many more people who really want a stronger community, who want to care for each other, who want rights for people and women's and LGBT and every race, every creed. And I was encouraged by that today. And I hope if you're watching anything that's going on, that you're seeing the people who are coming together and doing these marches. And know that they're not just protesting and not just complaining because they're sore losers. These are people who are going to lose their health care. People are going to lose some of their rights. We're already losing our environment. But I think today we showed that we're all pretty strong winners. Now more than ever, the government isn't of, by, and for the people right now. But we are the people, and we're still encouraging each other, we're still standing together, and I think we've become more of a community than we may have ever been before. And I hope that's so. If you're feeling frustrated, reach out to your neighbors. Reach out to the people around you. Realize that we're here to serve each other. We're here to love each other. And I think we'll get through this. Maybe not completely unscathed, but we will get through this.